I increased my 1% FPS on my PC by 45%, and you could do the same in the next few minutes. I'll show you all the tweaks and settings we need to do right after today's video sponsor. Waxpear, a reliable Counter-Strike 2 skins marketplace that is easy to use, instant item delivery, great prices, multiple deposit methods including crypto, and quick withdrawals. Buy your next skin on Waxpear, link is in the description below. Before we start, it's important to understand that I cannot guarantee similar FPS improvements on your setup. Every system is unique, so the results may vary. Let's begin with step 1, which is updating your Windows. Updating your Windows helps keep your system safe from vulnerabilities, and the impact on FPS isn't as significant as people think. Step 2 is to update your drivers. Open system information, copy your motherboard model, and paste it into a Google search. Go to your motherboard manufacturer's official website and download the drivers listed there. Step 3 is to set your Windows power plan to high performance. This prevents the system from going idle and enables all the cores of your processor. Also, adjust the performance options to best performance or follow the settings shown in the image. In step 4, we get rid of all the Windows bloatware apps. Below, you can see the before and after screenshots. To get this done, open PowerShell as an admin and run the command shown. All the extra apps will be removed. Once we are done with that, we will remove the existing graphic drivers using DDU uninstaller. It is highly recommended to use the clean and restart option. Step 6 is to install NVIDIA drivers using nvclean install. With this tool, you can get rid of all the NVIDIA bloatware. Make sure to select only the display driver if you do not use Shadowplay to record. Use the settings shown in the tweaks and install the drivers. Restart your PC once after you have installed the graphic drivers. In step 7, open the NVIDIA control panel and click Adjust Image Settings with Preview. Here, you have to click on Use the Advanced 3D Image Setting and hit Apply. On the left panel, click Manage 3D Settings and make sure to set Power Management Mode to Maximum Performance, Texture Filtering Quality to High Performance, and VSync off. Step 8 is optional. Here, you can do advanced NVIDIA settings using NVIDIA Profile Inspector. I have shown all the settings that I'm using in this tool in the screenshots. Next, we will get rid of Windows telemetry using WPD software. It's free to use, and once you have downloaded it, run it as an admin. Here, you have to click Disable and Block in the Privacy tab as shown. In the Blocker tab, you can choose Extra if you do not use Microsoft apps like Skype, Outlook, Microsoft Office, etc. We can also use the Shutup 10 app to configure Windows without bloat. Once you run this app as an admin, click on Actions and apply all the recommended settings. Then you can close the app. These are portable apps and you can delete them after you have used to configure your system. Step 10 is to set Windows graphics setting. Here, I personally keep Hardview Accelerated GPU Scheduling off and Game Mode on. You can benchmark your PC to see how they react. Next, we need to download Process Lasso, run it, and make sure you have CS2 running in the background. In the Active Processes tab, right-click CS2, click CPU Affinity, click Always, then click Set CPU Affinity. Here, you need to uncheck CPU 0 and click OK. In Process Lasso, click on Options, Tools, and then System Timer Resolution. Enter a value of 0.507, click Set, check Set at every boot, and apply globally. Then you can click OK. Now, go to CS2, right-click, and in Properties, set your first and only launch option, that is Threads. For this, open Task Manager And in the performance tab, check how many cores your CPU has. For mine, it was 6, so I used threads 7 in the launch option. The final step is the Steam settings. Go to the interface tab and disable smooth scrolling, GPU accelerated rendering, and hardware video decoding. This will help you save some resources for your FPS. I hope this tutorial helps your PC gain some FPS. Please share your opinion in the comments. Thank you for watching till the end.